Till now we have seen, I hope you have went through the notes I have shared, a strategic view of management information system. We have, I hope that you have gone through the notes. So I will discuss some, I will discuss in brief some points. So first of all, before discussing anything, let us recall what is management information system all about. So so management information system is basically we have to break before defining the whole terminology, we need to break the management information system in its three components. So first of all, system. What is a system? So basically, system is in broad sense we can say that a system is something which takes some input and gives some, processes it and gives some output. So broadly we can say any system, we can define any system as it takes some input and processes it and produces some output. So information system means you have to process some specific informations with help of some system. Information may be regarding anything. For example, in this case there are some, the information is regarded to some organization. In some other need, for example, it may be of some scientific purpose or some other industrial purpose, some demographic purpose, some sociological purpose. So information may be from any domain of study. So what is the definition of information? So we call, we know about data which we collect from different means. We can in notes we have I have mentioned in detail what how we can collect different data. So information is basically some useful data from which some meaning can be extracted from some data, then it is known as information. So we have defined system, that a system is something which takes input and processes it, then produces some output. And information is some useful data. We know about raw data. From raw data, we don't gather any particular information. For example, in 10th class, you all went through some statistics, statistical models like mean, median, mod. So we have some raw data and we processes it. So in that case, we process it manually and we find mean, mod. So here we can process the information. So we have discussed what is the information system. Information system is a automatic way to produce some raw data and to extract or gather some useful information, which may in turn will help in our some sort of decision making or some planning or some other thing for any new to establish some new venture, and lot of stuff is there. So information system is basically a automated way to produce some raw data in order to extract some useful knowledge. So now we are going to define what is management information system. So management information system is basically, as all you all of you know about management information system. So in any organization, there are some sort of management is there. So what is the work of management? Work of management is to run any organization smoothly, to make some decisions which will benefit the organization in long term. So now we are able to define what actually management information system is. So basically, management information system is the system which enables a organization, to process some data gathered and it in decision making. So we will go, we will see different type of decision making and what sort of decision making is needed in order to run a organization. So management information system is basically it helps in decision making for management body in an organization. So this whole course is divided in 5 units. In first unit, we will see a strategic view of management information system. In second unit, the notes I have already shared, and in second unit, basics of management information system. And in third unit, applications of management information system to e-business. And in fourth unit, application to management information system. And finally, there are 2 case studies, Tata Home Finance Limited and Engineering Product Limited. In case study, we will see how all these concepts we have discussed in the previous 4 units are applied in case of 2 organizations, Tata Home Finance Limited and Engineering Product Limited. So now we can start from a strategic view of management information system. So as we have discussed, introduction to it starts with a introduction to MIS. So concept we have already discussed, what is MIS? MIS is a sort of automated system which produces some data, some raw data gathered from different stakeholders. For any organization, there are different stakeholders. For example, for an organization which develops some commodity, the end user are the stakeholders. The financier is one of the stakeholders. The management is one of the stakeholders. The employees are other stakeholders. So in any organization, there are different stakeholders. The stakeholders varies from one enterprise to other enterprise. So for example, for a software product, we can say that a stakeholder is some end user who are actually going to use that software, and there are some customers are there which buys that software, and the programmer, the designer, the computer engineers involved in developing that software is one of the stakeholder. The management of that company is one of the stakeholder. So basically, management information system is to gather data, you can say data, and produces it in order to extract some useful knowledge in order to help the organization in decision making, so that it will help in organization in developing its business. So definition we have already mentioned in So what is definition of management information system? Management information system is a system consisting of people. As I have mentioned, that people are different stakeholders, machines, your system. There are some machines, there are procedures. You have to also mention different procedures. How you are going to, what sort of algorithm, what sort of models you are going to apply to extract information gathered from different people. Database, if you have some interest in computer engineering, then you must know that the information which we extract, we can't in order to process it by some machines, we need to store it efficiently. So the efficient storage of information is done through a database, and there are different data models. We will not go in technicality of what are different data models. So depending on different type of application or different type of organization, data models may be different. For example, a company is some sort of you can say a business, a commodity enterprise. For example, it is producing some food item like biscuits, and a company is some sort of service provider like a tour and travels, tour and travels agencies, or for or you can say like food delivery, or you can say taxi hiring company. So these all different type of domains have different type of applications, so their data may vary. So data models may vary because they need different type of data models in order to store their data and process that data. So depending on the type of enterprise, data models are different, and we can say and as its elements. So these are the basic elements of a management information system. So what are the essential elements of a management information system? First of all, we all must agree that the human are all sort of systems are human centric. So people are most important aspect of any system. So in management system, people are most important because ultimately they have to work, they have to decide, they have to perform some task decided already by management. Also, and in order to facilitate this decision making, machines, procedure, database, and data models are essential elements to have a management information system. So what does this system does? The system gathers data from the internal and external sources of an organization. So as we have already discussed, that stakeholders, some stakeholders are internal and some stakeholders are external. So people may be internal or external. So if you have some interest about testing procedure, then you must know about alpha and beta testing. If you some of you have information about have interest about software development, for example, if you download an application from Play Store, then you have an option to select that you want to be a beta tester. So some functionality, additional functionality is provided to you, and you are supposed to report any error or any changes in that in the application. So you become a beta tester. So you are an external source to that organization, and you are helping the organization to improve that their product. So and the alpha testing is where the end customer are called upon to organization and test the software product in order to find some problems or errors in the program. So you can say that the system gathers data from the internal external sources of an organization. So this is
excuse me sir. Beta tester or alpha tester, ye process hai ya koi tools hai?
No, these are alpha testing and beta testing is a process, but okay, the nature of testing is different. In alpha testing, people are called upon the at place of development, where the people who are developing the product is there, and they are guiding, and they are actually telling the person who is actually working on that product to that what are the functionality and what are the for example you can say what are the different aspects of this product. But in beta testing, it is released to end user, and they are supposed to report. They don't need to visit at the place where it provided to the customer at their end, and they are supposed to report any problem or any modification to the organization. So basically, it is in place. Alpha testing is in place, and it is at the user's place. So we have discussed what are the concept and what is definition and what is the role of. So now we are going to see what is the role of management information system. So as you know that when a company grows. So I request users, if there are some noise in surrounding, then I request that person to kindly mute his audio. If there is a noise in their surrounding, then I request that person to kindly mute their audios. So it is disturbing all of us. So otherwise, you can unmute your audio, and if you have to ask any question anytime, then you unmute your audio and you can ask any question. Feel free to ask any question. So all questions are most welcome. So we are discussing what is the role of management information system. So as we know, for a big organization. For example, I will take analogy of a democratic system. We are a democratic country in which for example, I can say to run our country, we choose member of parliament. So we cannot directly choose. In democratic system, what we know that every people has some rights, and every people are actually making their decision. But this decision making is not direct. Rather, they choose their representative, and the chosen legislators do legislation in order to govern all of the masses or to run the country. So we know that, for example, if I say that all citizens of India should gather at some place, and they raise their hands in order to decide about some issue, then it is not feasible. All we know that it is not feasible that all person gather somewhere and decide about something. So we developed. So in a democratic system, we developed a system of election. In that election, we choose our representative, and the representative in turn makes legislation and perform executive work in order to run the country smoothly. So similarly, for an organization, it is not possible manually to incorporate needs of all the stakeholders. So as we discussed, there are different stakeholders. All stakeholders have their different concerns are there. So it is not possible to accommodate the concerns of all stakeholders by just, for example, by questionnaire or manually asking or just have a meeting. So what we do, we develop some sort of automatic system. So in order to collect the information from all stakeholders and process it, and from that information, from that data, we extract some information, and that information is going to help us in decision making, which will actually, which is actually for betterment of the organization. So the role of management information system is to facilitate the organization in decision making, and the decision making is necessary for any organization. The management body are intended to they are actually there for decision making, because they don't have actual work to do. For example, engineers are supposed to do actual work for any organization. The engineers or workers or laborers are actually doing the work, but the management body are supposed to make decisions. So role of management information system is to automate the process of decision making. And how we automate this process of decision making? We gather different data from different stakeholders. We process with help of a system which we call here information system. So this will make the system as management information system, and it facilitates the managerial body of an organization to make the decisions which is helpful for the betterment, which is helpful for betterment of organization. So now the point is e-business enterprise. So as all of you know, e-business means here e-business means we all know what is e. E stands for, e means electronic. So any business which is done on some electronic platform, it is known as e-business. So e-business is a broader term. E-business is a broader term. There are different type of e-businesses. You can say many and many. You can make a long list of e-businesses. For example, all sort of e-commerce website, all sorts of tour and travels, also sort of taxi hiring, food delivery, and all sort of businesses. Any business which has which is on electronic platform, it is a e-business enterprise. So e-business is a broader term which incorporates all the business which is in which is on electronic platform. It may be some commodity based business, or it may be some sort of service provider. So e-commerce is a subset of e-business. E-commerce is a subset of e-business. E-commerce is where actually selling and buying of commodities are involved. If in some business where selling and buying of commodities are involved, then it is e-commerce. For example, Flipkart, Amazon, Alibaba, and you can make a long list. Myntra, and lot of you know better than me. These all sort of online shopping platforms. So these all are e-commerce. But e-commerce, we should not confuse about e-business and e-commerce. E-commerce, we can only say here, sale and purchase of commodities are involved. But e-business, for example, there is no sale and purchase of, for example, in Ola, there is no sale and purchase, because it is selling just a service. It is providing a network of drivers, which we hire, and there is not actually a buying or selling of commodity, but it is just a for example, you can say it is providing some sort of service. So e-business is a broader term, and e-commerce is a subset of e-business. So these are all terminology which is associated with management information system. For example, a business just move to, for example, a car manufacturing company. So you don't order, I think any one of us will not order a car from some online platform. Because if Flipkart is going to sell a car on their platform, then most of us will not do for example, purchasing of car on some online platform. We actually visit showroom and buy that car. But it is need of our for every organization to move their some sort of business to online platform. So all of the models are available there. You can get quotation of prices. You can put your queries that this is my need, this is my budget, and which of the model is suitable for me. So some sort of business is every organization which has some significant reach to the population is actually doing some sort of e-business is there. Maybe that business is only sort of information gathering, the actual benefit or actual some sort of trade is not involved there, but business is there in online platform. And e-commerce is when we directly purchase or sell something on some online platform, that it is e-commerce. And what is e-communication? E-communication is electronic communication basically. So we all know that communication is the communication. How we define a communication? Communication is transmission of some information from one place to another place. So in case of management information system, e-communication is necessary because with help of e-communication, we don't need to move from one place to another place. For example, if an organization wants to discuss with their client, then they don't. For example, the company is in US and client is in India. So with help of e-communication, if there is an interview schedule with the clients or some sort of discussion with clients for some product which the organization is supposed to develop, then with help of e-communication, for the actual physical movement is not there. So they can people from distant place can visit, take help of e-communication. And in today's world, for example, if you have seen some reports, then you can see that the whole world is going to change after this corona epidemic, because the world will not be like the world before corona. Because as all of you must heard about the term globalization. We due to advent of internet and the development of for example, you can say airlines, the world has become a global village. People are for business purpose, for tour purpose, people are going from this country to that country, different countries, and there is and people are just meeting from different country. So, but now in this scenario, where world is facing so much problem due to a virus, which we just originated from a country and it spread to all of the world. Currently, 202 country is affected by this virus. So you can just imagine that how much important going to e-communication. Although it is there, but reports are there that now it will be very much minimized. The culture of work from home will be going to be very much there. The people will be encouraged to work from their home, because no one will in such scenario, no one wants to be there. No individual or no organization wants people to gather there. So the world is going to change after this corona epidemic. So the role of e-communication will be much more appreciated in future time, although it is there. But people, for example, we are unable to go to our college, in which only 1,000 or 1,500 people are there. So we are not able to go to our college. We have to take help of e-communication mechanism to have our classes. So e-communication is there with advent of World Wide Web, email, and all messaging services, online social media, and other stuffs. But it will get more appreciated in future time. And what is e-collaboration? E-collaboration is basically collaboration. We all know collaborate means to help each other for example, collaborate means to.
Hi.
Hello. E-collaboration means when different stakeholders are putting forward their views, their skills to have some work, to have to some useful work. So we know it at collaboration. For example, if I tell you that you have to develop a drone to monitor, for example, in current scenario, if I take example of current scenario, you have to develop a drone to monitor the roads in current. We are facing a lot now, and it is very tough for government to actually enforce the lockdown, because people don't have in India, people are not so educated. They are reluctant to follow any order by government. So it is very tough for government to actually implement this lockdown. We all know about it. So, and for law enforcement agencies like military or police, it is not possible to, because their personnel are also limited. For example, in Bihar, you can say that there are some. So you can't say that in whole of Bailey Road, at every place, in Patna, in Bailey Road, at every place, or every 10 meter, there is some. If we are going to distribute whole police personnel in Patna, then it is not possible for us to deploy all the police on roads only. So in that case, if government say, for example, chooses our college, that teachers and students should collaborate to develop a model of drone in 15 days, in 1 month, in order to monitor the roads. With help of drone, we may deploy 100 drones in Patna, and at one place only, for example, 10 people are needed, which will actually we see the images of images gathered from the drone. So in that case, to develop a drone, you all know that we need collaboration of mechanical engineering, because a drone has arms and other, it is flying, so fluid machinery is there and some parts are there. So we need electrical engineering and electronics engineering, because some electronic circuitry are there. We need computer engineering, because all parts we can't implement in hardware. Some software is needed there. Some coding is needed there. So we need collaboration of faculties and students of computer engineering, electrical and electronics engineering, mechanical engineering, in order to develop a drone in short time. For example, if I say that I give task to develop a drone to a student of mechanical engineering, then I will not say that he can't develop. But if time is constrained, for example, you have to develop it in 5 days or 10 days or 1 month, time is there. So collaboration is needed. For example, people are collaborating to develop Corona, you can say, what is that? Corona, what is term for that? Corona, jisko Hindi mein tika kehte hain. Angrezi mein kya kehte hain? Corona.
Vaccine.
Vaccine. Corona vaccine. So people are researchers from chemistry and researchers from zoology and different medical professionals. So all people are collaborating to develop a vaccine. So collaboration may be where people are actually gathering at some place. And if this collaboration is done online with help of an electronic mechanism, then it is known as e-collaboration. So in e-collaboration, people are at, for example, someone are working at IIT Delhi, some are working at IISER Pune, some are working at ISRO, some are working at Bhabhai Atomic Research Center. So these people are CSIR, some people are working, and a lot of scientific organization are there. So many people many scientists, for example, life science researchers, chemistry researchers. So collaboration of all person are needed. And in such situation, they can't gather at one place. So in that case, they, for example, we are just taking help of some e-mechanism, online mechanism to have our classes. So if such facility is there to where people can collaborate online, so that facility is known as e-collaboration. So what we have discussed today? We have discussed today the introduction to MIS, where we have discussed the different aspects of management information system. We have discussed concept of information system, definition of information system, role of information system, and one thing I have left, that impact of information system. So you can say that impact of information system is it basically cut the cost of decision making. So decision making, if people actually gather somewhere, then you have to provide them lodging facility, you have to provide them fooding facility, you have to these are some basic facilities. They have to finance their travel. So these all cost may be cut through if we apply management information system. We take help of all the for example e-communication, e-collaboration is there, then we can impact of online management system. You can mention lot of cost cutting, the decision making fast. For example, if the processing of data is done manually, then it is slow, and if it is done automatically with help of a computer system, then it is fast. So cost cutting is there, the speed is there. So and we have seen e-business enterprises, and in that topic we have seen in e-business, e-commerce, e-communication, e-collaboration. So in next class